Please start making your ways to your seats. Procession will begin in 5 minutes. Please make your way to your seats. Procession will begin in 5 minutes. Please make your way to your seats. We will begin in just 2 minutes. Please make your way to your seats. We are beginning in 2 minutes.
I see it. Thank you. morning. Good morning. Welcome to today's commencement ceremony for the class of 2023. We're delighted that you could join us for this auspicious occasion. I ask that you remain standing as you're able for the national anthem and invocation. Bishop Singers, please come forward.
Together to celebrate the class of 2023. After many years of hard work and perseverance, their time here has come to a close. We give thanks for the gift they have been to this community and for the people who have supported and encouraged them along the way. We ask your blessing upon them today as they join the ranks of alumni of the school. As they step out onto new ground, may the values they have learned and lived here, integrity, inclusion, compassion, and justice, continue to shape how they live and move and have their being in the world. Give them compassion for all people, generous and humble hearts that they might serve others, reverence and respect for all of creation, hope for a world where peace is built with justice and justice is guided by love. May their longing for all that is right and good and true be their life's compass, and may your love gather, mind, and shelter them in eternal belonging all the days of their lives. Amen. You may be seated.
Thank you, Reverend Simopoulos. Graduates, parents, guardians, families, and friends, thank you for joining us for this celebratory occasion. I know you have come from near and some from far for the Bishop School's 114th commencement. We give thanks for your presence here. I know it means a lot to our graduates to see all of you here. It is our honor every year to have Bishop Susan Brown Snook, Bishop of the Episcopal Diocese of San Diego, and Chair of the Bishop's School's Board of Trustees, with us for baccalaureate and for commencement. Bishop Brown Snook had an urgent situation arise, and she sends her apologies and prayers for the graduates. And today, Reverend Simopoulos Bigato will share her greeting on her behalf.
On behalf of Bishop Susan Brown Snook, congratulations to the class of 2023. The Bishop School is more than a school. Of course, it is a school, a place where you've learned from good friends, great teachers, and challenging academics. But it's more than just a place to learn. It's also a place to grow. Because it's not just academics that this school teaches. It's the emotional skills of dedication, teamwork, and compassion that you've practiced here that will help you succeed wherever you find yourselves next. And it's the character that you've built through these years of education that will make you citizens of your community, ready to improve the world. The values you've practiced, integrity, inclusion, compassion, and justice, are exactly the values our world needs right now. So congratulations on giving your best at a school that has always demanded your best. You have been given a rare gift here, the gift of a community that dedicates itself to ensuring your well-being. As you graduate and go out into the world, Bishop Susan asks you to use the gifts you have been given to make the world a better place. Do justice, love kindness, walk humbly with God, serve your community, care for others.
It is now my privilege to grant awards to members of this graduating class. Most of these awards were given with the intention that they be presented at the commencement ceremony. I'll ask the recipients to come forward, and please note that I'm going to read the awards in a slightly different order than which they're listed in your program. First, the Judith M. Haxo Award. The Judith M. Haxo Award is presented to a senior who is nominated by the faculty and elected by the senior class for taking initiative and having the courage to pursue passions, even if that entails standing apart. This student is described by a classmate as one of the most creative and driven people he knows. She's a student who is unswayed by the crowd, who is ready for adventure, who charges forward when others hesitate. Her indomitable spirit and independent and original style are manifest in her surfing, her writing, and her poetry. I'm sorry, pottery. I'm sure she writes poems too. Okay. She does not seek awards, no other forms of validation. The only affirmation she needs is her own. Despite her extraordinary talents, this student is genuinely kind-hearted, humble, and deeply supportive of her friends and classmates. In recognition of these qualities, the award goes to Rory Ng. The Richard and Margaret Farr Award. This award is given to a senior for perseverance, dependability, and concern for others. You would be hard-pressed to find a more accomplished or more humble student. She leads a bevy of on-campus affinity spaces and clubs, including LASSO, Speech and Debate, Robotics, and Chapel Council, all while playing first violin and varsity basketball. Her service work, teaching coding lessons in Spanish to students in underserved communities in San Diego and Tijuana, have earned her national recognition. When she noticed the dearth of Spanish language resources for computer coding, she wrote an illustrated guidebook. For her selfless commitment to bishops and to the world beyond, we're honored to award Richard and Margaret Farr Award to Athena Hernandez. The Harvard Cup was first awarded at the San Miguel School for Boys in 1953. It was given each year to the seniors having the highest cumulative grade point average. The tradition continued in 1971 when San Miguel merged with the Bishop School. Since that time, the Harvard Cup has been awarded to the senior with the highest academic record. This year's Harvard Cup goes to Eli Brown. The recipients of these next awards were nominated by the Bishop's faculty, and they were selected among a class of students with remarkable talents and accomplishments. With the following awards, we honor outstanding academic achievement, leadership, and character. The Head of School Award. The Head of School Award is given to students nominated by the faculty and honored by the Head of School for significant contributions to the school's various programs. The recipients may have held leadership roles, been scoring leaders or stars in the show, or they may have led in supporting roles in any number of areas. This year we have six recipients. This student radiates welcoming. A teammate in the water, on the court, occasionally on the green, his joie de vivre is an invitation to all. One teacher says he is a beacon of positivity. Another calls him a kind and caring mentor to younger students. He's a pillar of integrity. He does the right thing for the right reason. From theater to athletics, as a head ambassador for admissions, and as ASBC president, his fearless try-anything approach has touched many corners of our campus, and we're better for it. We're pleased to present the Head of School Award to Ryan Arrowsmith. This student is passionate, curious, and smart as a whip. She radiates integrity, and when she cares about something, she pursues it with commitment and determination. He is fiercely dedicated to the serious work of protecting our planet and has spearheaded campus initiatives to reduce plastic and to increase composting. She has delivered numerous chapel talks, nudging this community toward greater sustainability, sharing her love of music, as well as her commitment to her Jewish faith. Sarah Kaplan is a force who pushes us to be better each day. We're pleased to offer her the Head of School Award. Steadfast and eager, this student is everyone's go-to. He's a passionate driver of social innovation and community service, and is a competitive and joyful force on the cross-country and track teams. As a leader in ASBC, this Johnny on the spot arranged to walk to La Jolla High School, coordinated our Veterans Day Assembly, co-hosted this sweet celebration, grew a world-class mustache to host Family Feud. However, his greatest gift to bishops is how special he makes others feel. One classmate likened him to being the bishop's dad. He betters this community every day, and we're pleased to give the Head of School Award to Joshua Lee. Relentless, ferocious, or dogged might not be the first words that spring to mind to describe her. exuberant, warm, or joyful may leap more readily to the fore, but all are true. She's a fierce athlete and inspirational captain on the field hockey pitch. She's a serious and proficient cellist in orchestra and jazz band, and a workhorse in student government. There don't seem to be enough hours in the day, but this student does it all, touching every corner of this campus with spirit and a deep love for bishops. We're so pleased to offer a head of school award to Novelin Patricus. Respected among peers, loyal to friends, and deeply kind, this student contributes as a learner and a leader, holding himself to impressively high standards, rising to tasks and challenges before him, and serving as an example to others. He's a humble but unflappable force, and an affinity group leader and a student diversity leadership conference leader who has given all to also to his baseball, track, basketball, and football teams. After many transitions and moves in his life, we're glad that he found a home that he has loved. We're pleased to honor Raynald Thornton with the Head of School Award. The final Head of School awardee is an inquisitive bibliophile who embraces the life of the mind. He seeks out peers and adults alike to dig into salient topics from class as well as into life's big questions. An outspoken advocate for justice and neurodiversity and a member of the DEIJ Advisory Board, the student is also a head ambassador for admissions, a captain of both the football and lacrosse teams, and a co-founder of Social Innovations Code for Good. Above all, he's a humble and kind person who models integrity. Our final Head of School award recipient is Hewitt Watkins. The Bishop's Medal. The Bishop's Medal is awarded by the faculty each year to the senior who has been most involved in the total life of the school. This student has excelled academically, led with confidence, and served with compassion during her time at Bishop's. She is a team captain, senior class president, and is both a performing and visual artist. She champions social justice as an active member of San Diego's API Coalition, and has collaborated with students all over the country in her DEIJ work. For her contributions to the total life of our school, we present the Bishop's Medal to Caitlin Wong. Michael W. Titleman Loyalty Cup. This cup, named after Bishop's 10th head of school, is our top award, given to a member of the senior class who has consistently demonstrated loyalty, excellence, and integrity in all aspects of student life. With interests that run the gamut from speech and debate, to squash, to volleyball, to peer support, to leading voter registration drives both on campus and in the larger community, what sets this student apart is his selflessness and genuine concern for others. He does what good leaders do. He volunteers for the hardest work, avoids the spotlight, credits others, and does it all with positivity and enthusiasm. Will Keefe, He's a dynamic change maker, and we're pleased to offer him the Michael W. Tiedemann Loyalty Cup. It is now my pleasure to introduce the president of the class of 2023. She has served this class and the school wonderfully this year. Caitlin Wong, president of the class of 2023, please come to the podium to share your parting thoughts.
Good morning, everybody. My name is Caitlin, and I want to start by thanking my mentors who have shaped my mind and soul into its ever-growing form. In particular, I want to thank Coach James. You've shown me how truly great this world is. And of course, I must thank my parents. You two have given me absolutely everything, and no matter how much I love my passions in this world, it will never surpass the love you've shown to me. In kindergarten, we were told a brave and powerful line, just be yourself. I had no idea what that meant, and perhaps many of you had no idea what that meant either. But now, as an adult, I think I know what it means. I have to admit, some of my classmates seem to have figured that out before I did, whether just being yourself meant plastering your face as a meme all over the rec room as inspirational messaging, or slip and sliding shirtless in front of very confused sixth graders, or singing in the chapel like it's shower karaoke. Just be yourself. 2 years ago, I was sitting in Mr. Thompson's office, and I was asking him about how to enact change in the bishop's community. I said something along the lines of, I want to do something, like a big something, soon. He looked at me and said, relax. Let's make sure that first of all, you are all right. And I was so shocked. It seemed like the world was falling apart, going up in flames. Nothing was okay, and this man was going to sit here and tell me to what? Have a come to Jesus moment? I wanted to resist and say that I did not have the time to do all of that when the world needed me then. And despite that, Mr. Thompson directed me to an affinity space. And in that group, I found my people. I found the solidarity to stand up. And the truth is that despite all the waiting, despite that, I learned that to help others, I had to first help myself. To love, believe in, and trust in myself. My hope for this graduating class of 2023 is that you keep doing what you're meant to do. This hat. What you love to do. That you all thrive in what your heart has pulled you towards. Because when I look at this class, I see a future of greatness. Greatness not just in the things you will do, but in how you will do it. There's something I heard recently that I really liked. And it was something along the lines of, if you place a person at the bottom of a, that's it. I graduated early. There's something recently that I heard, and it was something along the lines of, if you place a person at the bottom of a hill and you ask them to estimate the distance to the top of the hill versus if you place a loved one next to them and you ask the same person standing in the same spot to estimate that same hill, they will give you a distance that is shorter when they're with someone. And I was really touched by this message of companionship and dependency. And not to be a Debbie Downer, but I realized that it's really difficult to be there for somebody else when you're not the best at being there for yourself. You have to be your biggest believer. And I want you all to look at that hill. And even when no one else is by your side, to love yourself enough to work towards where you have to be. Because serving as your senior class president, I'm very impressed, not by the things you've done, but how you do it. Whether it was, you see, I'm not impressed by the way of our average singing skill during our final You Raise Me Up, but I am impressed by how we sing with one another, arm in arm, like in Broadway. I'm not interested in the grades we earn, but I'm fascinated by the way we study with one another and conquer Mr. Hallback's room during office hours. I'm not impressed by the buzzer beater you swished, but by your resilience and confidence to shoot the ball despite it all. And I'm not impressed by the way no one snapped a limb on the slip and slide, though I am actually kind of impressed by that. Because what I want to say is that class of 2023, as a senior, one of the biggest things I've had to learn is that there were moments where my desire to attain success tempted me to compromise my integrity. I asked myself, what if I'd been doing everything wrong this entire time? Would I be more successful doing something else? And the truth is, passion cannot be wrong. What's right is doing what you love, and it's not worth it to give that up. Class of 2023, I could send you all off to college with enormous wishes that you work hard every day, continue pushing the boundaries of what you're passionate about, or make the most out of every little thing. But all that is not necessary. I want to send you off with what we all learned in kindergarten. Just be yourself. Thank you.
Thank you, Caitlin. It is now my pleasure to introduce another student leader, Ryan Arrowsmith, president of the Associated Student Body Council. Ryan has led us conscientiously and with care this year. Ryan, please come forward.
Good morning, everyone. My name is Ryan Arrowsmith, and it has been my honor to serve as the student body president this year. When preparing for this speech, I was reminded of a certain college essay I had to write this past fall. The prompt was, if you had 10 minutes and the attention of a million people, what would you say? Well, we're not a million people, and I didn't get into that college anyway, so I'm going to try something new today. As an 18-year-old, it is overwhelming to think about what kind of advice I can give to my fellow peers. But just like all of you here, I've gone through my own personal journey with my own challenges to learn from. Just this past year, my family dealt with serious health issues, and even this past month, I was unfortunately witness to a traumatic event while at work. That's the time when I leaned on my family, my close friends, my strong support system here at school. It doesn't matter how old you are, because at some point, all of us have or will experience serious, real-life challenges. It is how you deal with them in the moment and advance forward that matters most. One of my mom's favorite sayings is, Ryan, clean up your room. Sorry. I meant to say, her favorite saying is, you can't control the wind, but you can adjust your sails. Sometimes that slight shift in perspective is all you need. Anyone who knows me knows that I'm a diehard Sacramento Kings fan. My whole life, the Kings have been awful, until this year. But what was different? To me, the biggest difference was a change in the team's perspective. Allow me to explain. This year, the Kings installed a massive purple laser on top of their stadium that would shoot up into the sky after every win. They did this all year in what they called lighting the beam. My Kings went on to have their best season in my lifetime, making the playoffs and lighting the beam countless times on their way. Unfortunately, they got eliminated and fell short of winning the NBA Finals, their end goal. But the beam taught me a valuable lesson. In life, we won't always achieve what we initially set out to do. We will fall short. We will struggle. But as the Kings did, it is important to celebrate the little wins along the way. Even if you don't get that grade, you don't get that job, find a way to light the beam. Don't get too lost in the end goal. Throughout my experience at Bishop's, I've been able to mess up. I've come up short many times here, whether it be on an econ quiz or in the pool playing water polo. But what's great about this place is the safety blanket it provides. I'm not worried about messing up here. In fact, this was the place for me to try all sorts of new things, to see what works and what doesn't. In the coming years, we won't have that same security. It's going to be scarier to fail. The stakes seem higher. But there's nobody more prepared for those challenges than the class of 2023. Standing on the stage, I'm surrounded by some of the brightest and most impressive people that I've ever met. But as smart as my peers are, that's not why I know they'll persevere. I've been lucky enough to spend 7 years of my life with this group, and I can confidently say that it is who they are at their core that will make them succeed. This class is full of hardworking, resilient, and thoughtful people who have pushed me every step of the way. As much as I have Bishop's to thank for preparing me for the future, the biggest thank you goes to my classmates. They have taught me so many lessons and helped shape who I am today. They're part of the reason why I know I'll be able to deal with the next challenge in my life. The same can be said about my teachers. Yes, I learned so much from Mr. Hallback and the way he could rattle off information about any given historical event, or from Mrs. Beamer in the way she led me through my first year of Bishop's Math. But the main takeaways are not the contents of their lessons. It's the way in which they make you feel at home in their classroom, the way in which they're eager to help you maximize your learning, or the way in which they're there to listen about anything going on outside of just history or math. That's the magic of this place. Last week, when I went to a reunion for my elementary school, I saw people who I'd spent 9 years of my life with, but hadn't seen one time since I left after fifth grade. And as sad as that reality is, it is likely going to be the same here. There are so many of you on this stage who I may not see until our 10-year reunion. Despite the role we have all played in each other's lives, we will go down our own paths that may not cross for a very long time. These people and this place, which has been a constant in my life, will slowly fade. There are no more memories to make on this campus. Of course, each of us will maintain a relationship with our closest friends, but I'm talking about the seemingly trivial interactions across this campus, a passing high five in Scripps, a conversation in advisory, that one joke at the cafeteria table. These moments may not seem like the biggest from high school, but each one has its own value to me. And as much as it saddens me to think I won't see some of my peers again, all I can say is thank you. My experience here would not have been the same without each of you. When I began the year with a speech at matriculation, I told people to get out there and try new things, meet new people, and to not let fear hold them back. So I want to end the year with that same message going into college. Except this time, I hope you will also take the time to reflect and keep in touch with old friends as well. At graduation, people tend to look forward to what's coming in their immediate future. But as an aspiring history major myself, I think the most important lessons can often be learned from looking back. So as we head out into the world, make sure to remember those lessons and those people from your time here at Bishop's. Thank you all, and for the last time, roll Knights!
Thank you, Ryan. So as I listen to Caitlin and Ryan, I'm reminded of what a privilege it is to work with and be with these students every day over many years. They're remarkable people. So I'd like to begin my comments at commencement ceremonies first with a reminder that today is for you seniors, and so much of this day is really more so for your parents, guardians, and families. Your achievement is a culmination of their love, devotion, and sacrifice. Parenting does not follow a clear path. And I commend all the parents and guardians for everything that you have done for your children over many years that have led to this moment. Graduates, please don't let this day pass without saying thank you to everyone in your family who has made this day possible. Now, 2 weeks ago today, in St. Mary's Chapel, right over there, seniors gathered for their final chapel service. In speech, song, and music, it's a program by seniors, for seniors, that emphasizes affection, appreciation, and reflection. Reverend Somopoulos includes a faculty speaker, prayers, and reminders of God's love for them. During the school year, while we welcome students to come to chapel, pause, reflect, and center themselves on the service in the middle of a busy day, that can be hard to do. You know, it's what came before, they're thinking about what comes after, and the senior year is busy that way, and even more so than most years. On this day, for the final chapel, the seniors were together, celebrating being together, fully present, and as happens when one is fully absorbed, one becomes less conscious of the passage of time. But I could see that Reverend Somopoulos was tracking the time carefully. Prior to the service, she had asked each speaker and performer for their submissions in advance, and she timed each speech, each musical piece, each prayer. We had started on time, yet for some reason the service was running long. Inside, she texted an update on our timing to those outside. We knew that while the seniors were soaking in their final chapel service, the other 670 Bishop students were waiting, lined up around the perimeter of the quad from the chapel and all the way to the alumni courtyard outside of Taylor Theater. Starting with grade 6 and culminating with grade 11, they were waiting to cheer on the seniors as they made their final way around what is known as the senior salute. The appointed time for the seniors' emergence from the chapel came and went. Some more time passed, and 670 underclassmen who were in hurry-up-and-wait mode were getting restless. So Reverend Somopoulos started to make alterations on the fly. She whispered to a student that we would not be able to recite the prayers as planned, and we would instead pray for the seniors at the baccalaureate service. I saw the student nodding in agreement. She scanned the program for other revisions. She went to the lectern and announced, since we had run out of time, we would not be able to sing the final song on the program, You Raise Me Up, and that we... It wasn't possible to hear what she said next because the seniors erupted in a universal plea. No! We have to! Just one stanza, please! You may not know this song, You Raise Me Up, and even if you do, you may be wondering what prompted such an immediate and vocal reaction from our seniors. That question has been on my mind, too. So let me take you back a moment. So first, for those of you who are unfamiliar, you may be wondering, what does this song have to say? The song itself is short and not complex. The lyrics are as follows. Verse 1. It's gonna sound strange to read this. Okay. Verse 1. When I am down and oh, my soul so weary. When troubles come and my heart burdened be, then I am still and wait here in the silence until you come and sit a while with me. You know, you raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. Verse 2. There is no life, no life without its hunger. Each restless heart beats so imperfectly. But when you come and I am filled with wonder. Sometimes I think I glimpse eternity. You raise me up so I can stand on mountains. You raise me up to walk on stormy seas. I am strong when I am on your shoulders. You raise me up to more than I can be. And then finally, you raise me up to more than I can be. Sounds better when you actually hear it to music. This song was originally recorded in 2001 by a Norwegian musician and Irish songwriter and met immediate obscurity. It wasn't until 2 years later that American singer Josh Groban hit the charts with the song, which he performed at the 2004 Super Bowl, and then to seal its legendary status, he sang it to Oprah Winfrey on her 50th birthday. Now, when you hear the simple lyrics, you may not be thinking literary classic or deep hidden meaning, but it struck a popular chord. The song eventually made its way to bishops in 2014 when then-chaplain Brian Fiddler introduced it. And it has since become a staple of the final chapel service under Reverend Samopoulos. Now, our seniors love traditions. The maroon polo, the senior rec room, no walking on the quad, milk break. So the seniors' cries to sing, "You Raise Me Up," at their last chapel can be explained, at least in part, by the commitment to familiar rituals. But I know that there is more to it. And if the lyrics are not hiding secrets, the students' feelings, though, are revealing. So let's recall that this group of seniors began high school in the fall of 2019. Two-thirds of their freshman year felt like a normal year, and then they were all sent home in the spring. Their sophomore year began with mostly online school and increasingly in-person instruction until the spring when vaccines arrived and they could be on campus every day. Most of their sophomore year, they couldn't play sports, and then they played almost all of them simultaneously. Performing arts, when we could have them, were outdoors. Last year, their junior year, felt more normal, but masks were common, and we still had disruptions from new variants of the virus. This year, for the first time since their freshman fall, the year felt normal, and it felt like it was going to stay normal. For this graduating class, no 1 year of upper school was like the previous year, and some experiences were different from what they had hoped. The seniors, I know it was hard to go through this, to not know what was going to happen next. There were times, I'm sure, when you were down and you felt weary. And the only way you got through this was together, by supporting each other as a community. That comment about community may not feel surprising to you, given your experience at this school. Ryan talks a lot about it in his talk. But this feeling of community is not common. There is, in American life, a perpetual tension between the freedom and aspirations that each of us has as individuals and our obligations to a greater community beyond ourselves that has made our individual success possible. And I worry sometimes that our national dialogue poses this tension as a one or the other when we know that it has to be both. Now think of how this tension plays out in this song and imagine if it were different. Imagine if it were called "I Raise Me Up," and you sang, "I raise me up to more than I can be." It's kind of absurd. It's unimaginable. Unimaginable that you seniors would have been clamoring to sing a song about yourself and about your own personal pursuits. And certainly you've accomplished much individually, but we all recognize that we experienced so much more because we loved and cared for each other, gave to each other, and did more together than we could have done alone. And I wish for you to continue to find communities where you can find such fulfillment. The essential message of this simple but meaningful song is that it reminds us continually that there is some second person, some you, who raised you up. In that final senior chapel, I saw many arms slung around shoulders of best friends. Your friend was the one who raised you up. In the senior salute line, it was the teacher or coach you embraced who had raised you up. Here today, it's your family who raised you up. As an Episcopal school, we sing that song in chapel because the you may be the God you know and experience in your life. So as I was saying, Reverend Simopoulos was looking at the time, and she tried to explain to all of you that we didn't have time to sing You Raise Me Up. I was sitting behind her, and she turned to me as we heard the appeals, and we exchanged a look that recognized that there was only one thing we could do. I gave her a thumbs up, the organ started, and the graduates sang the loudest version of the song, and likely the loudest version of any song to come from St. Mary's Chapel since 1916. For the hundreds of students, faculty, and staff who were waiting outside for them, it was their cue that the seniors had raised each other up one last time. In closing, it's typical at graduations for a speaker to tell seniors about all the problems in the world and that we hope that you're the generation that will fix them. I've always found this message hopeful and also somewhat unfair. Many of you are more focused, and appropriately so, on finding a summer job or figuring out what classes to take in the fall and hoping that you get along with your future college roommate. So I won't ask more than is fair, but I'll offer a reminder and a hope. You don't have to solve all the problems of the world, but nor can you ignore them. You can live a life of greater purpose by doing what you practiced and experienced here, raising up others, helping them succeed, and seeking out those who share your values. Class of 2023, you have been loved by the school community. We have given you everything we can. And now it's time for us to say goodbye. We ask that you take care of yourselves, take care of others, and visit often. We'll always be delighted to see you. Thank you. Now, we come to the most important award of all, the Bishop's School Diploma. This diploma represents a combination of academic achievement and personal qualities that have been developed over time. It's earned through discipline of mind and the development of oneself. It represents achievement, sure, but also those special qualities of intellect and character that are uniquely those of a Bishop's graduate. Now, as a reminder, after receiving your diploma, you're going to pause for a photo. When you depart the stage, you will receive a lay from Ms. Gomez and pose for a photo. Mr. Brian Ogden, Assistant Head for Curriculum and Academics, and Ms. Janice Mibarashi, Assistant Head for Adolescent Learning and Development, will assist in the reading of the names of our graduates and in the presentation of diplomas.
Jasmine Andeja Joseph. Sarah Elizabeth Kaplan. Ethan Min Marquez. Rex Pavel Harrison. Eli William Brown. Current trustee, Julie O. Brown, will present the diploma to her son. Alexander Zarku. Shirley Tianfei Xu. Maya Anna Krolik. Grace Sun. Nicola Sophia McKenzie Xanthopoulos. Current trustee Gaylene Xanthopoulos will present the diploma for her child. Rio Ishikawa. Koshi Eguchi. William Bowen. Wyatt Albert Lingy. Evan Yifan Ben. Lucille Marie Pruel. Matthew Jasper Erdman, current trustee Rick Erdman, and present the diploma to his child. Calvin Berkeley Frericks. Edward Chow. Naohiro Nadahara. Natasha Lai Ling Mar. Luke Hayden Seltzer, current trustee Tyler Seltzer will present the diploma to his child. Gabrielle Sage Rosen. Charlotte Louise Banta, current faculty member David Banta will present the diploma to his child. Lucas Michael Ball. Elizabeth Marilee Rogers. Yeah. Casey Haiching Lam. Jaden Amaru Moore. Jay Han Udinski. Alex Dat Win. Ryan Zachary Davis. Deborah Ann Simmons Arnold. Kiara Isabella Marmania. Eliana Josephine Birnbaum Nong. Lisbon Miley Ziegler. George Joseph Voorhees Ellis. Emily Joe. Jasmine Eliza Louise Rodriguez. Michelle Alyssa Chen. Tyler Jason Hagen. George James Mattis. Jackson Clyde Wolford. James Arnold Ho. Hewitt Gabriel Thomas Watkins. William Shoshin Lai. Everett Reed Forte. Jack Christopher Castagnola. Maddie Alexa Ishaya. Audrey Lee Ann. Chloe Trang Richmond. Henry Marshall Nelson. Yao Yu Hausen Wu. Arjun Ajit Raisangani, current trustee, Sonia Ramamurthy, will present the diploma to her child. Arya Liao. Camille Ray Greenlee. Huetza Crystal Lee. Rory Lynn Ang. Sebastian Garmanieto. Catherine Alyssa Silva. Casey Martin Ryan. Owen David Ebel. William Hill Keith. Aiden Cole Kaplan. Brooke Fitz Cluster. Annalise Yungja Chang.
Alejandro Gonzalez. Yuto Noah Fraley. Caitlin Wong. Catherine Rose Donnelly. William Fierro. Raj Narayan Sugavanam. Jameson David Vaccaro. Ray Joseph Thornton III. James Andrew Stutz III. Phoebe Paredes. Catalina Ann McFarland. Nancy Waldman. Laurel Daly. Jake Aaron Molinar. Aiden Anthony Doros. Dorian Zhang. Neve Karen Malhotra. Kate Paige Peterson. Current trustee Colleen Peterson will present the diploma to her child. Alexandra Ann Houck. Kate Maxim Weatherup. Mihir Bagatwala. Ashir Bhushan Kashyap. Bennett Joseph Chattero. Daniel Minhao Xu. Chase Woodward Landa. Alexander Wells Goldman. Joshua Aiden Lee. Athena Coca Hernandez. Grayson Arden Goldberg. Aiden Ishio Chang. Aiden will ring a bell to signify completion of cancer treatment. Bianca Mercedes Zaria. Catherine Holly Steinmeier. Matthew Bien. Ariston Sam James Oates. Alexander Ryan Yang. Kenneth Cheong. Eve Mays Paris. Nalawen Faye Patricus. Emily Kimbara Zhu. Isabel Sophia Merced Galindo. Jasper Jane. Luca Gebelber. Zed Aslam. Jordan Jim Merriam. Erica Nicole Pfister. Luca Mateo Navarro. Shay Alcon Rueda. Xavier Luis Rodriguez. Dax Gutkunst. Macy Gabrielle Harrow. Alexander Joseph Berger. Kelsey Alexander Morrison. Will Kessler. Lyle Allison LaRocca. Emma Teresa Meyer. Abigail Lynn. Alicia Joe. Oliver Lakenin Price. Current trustee Lake Price will present the diploma to his child. Tara Lavanya Sugavana. Julia Michaela Bonaguidi. Sydney Elise Bold. Ryan Dean Arrowsmith. Current trustee Peter Arrowsmith will present the diploma to his child. Avery Chase Upton. Aaron Eastman Ellsworth. Pierce Reinhold Wagner. And last but not least, Jonathan Neglin.
Everyone, I am honored to present to you the Bishop's Class of 2023. I see that you're trying to churn things and maybe thinking about throwing something. Not yet. Okay. But graduates, please stand. I now ask you to join in the tradition of the churning of the tassel, which symbolizes that you have earned your diploma. Graduates, please turn your tassel by moving it from the right side to the left side. Please remain standing. Please remain standing for the school hymn, prayer, and benediction. I'd like to welcome the bishop singers.
Please sing along. There's no notes in your program. So go where your heart tells you to.
But listen to the trumpets.
The trumpets are playing the melody.
Let us pray. Bless, O God, this school. Make us ready to be taught and willing to serve. Enrich us with faithfulness and loving wisdom. Quicken our minds in the desire for knowledge and our hearts in the love of virtue. Deliver us from fear of that which is new and from scorn of that which is old. Strengthen us in body and spirit, that we may be prepared for service to our country and the world. In your name we pray. Amen. And now for a blessing. Class of 2023, faculty, staff, family, and friends. Life is short, and we do not have much time to gladden the hearts of those who make the way with us. So be swift to love and make haste to be kind. Do justice, love kindness, walk humbly, honor all people, love and serve God and one another. And the blessing of God, the God who made us, who loves us, and who travels the way with us, be upon you and remain with you always. Amen.
Family and friends, faculty and staff, please join me in one last tribute to the class of 2023.
Thank you.